Hi friends, welcome to Storytime with Tristan. Tomorrow, many people in America will celebrate Thanksgiving. Does your family have a special tradition or things that they like to eat on Thanksgiving Day? In our story today, our character Tuit is a little nervous about what her teacher and the kids in her class will think about what her family eats for Thanksgiving. Let's find out more about Tuit's family and how they celebrate Thanksgiving. Duck for Turkey Day by Jacqueline Jules and illustrated by Catherine Mitter. To get ready for Thanksgiving, Tuit's class sang turkey songs. They made pinecone turkeys. They talked about pilgrims and Native Americans. "See you on Monday," Mrs. Cook said when the bell rang. "Have a great turkey day." Tuit was excited about the Thanksgiving holiday. They would get 3 days off from school. But there was something important she had to talk to Mama about. "Mama," Tuit said as soon as she got home, "we need a turkey for Thanksgiving." "No, we don't," Mama smiled. "We'll buy duck at the market." "But everybody else will have turkey," Tuit said. That afternoon, Ba Noy arrived from New York. Tuit hugged her grandmother. "We're having duck for Thanksgiving dinner." "I know," Ba Noy said. "We're using my recipe from Vietnam." "Everybody else has turkey." "Our family likes duck better," Ba Noy answered. Back home, Tuit went to her bedroom. She pulled her pinecone turkey out of her backpack. "Mama and Ba Noy don't know the rules about Thanksgiving," she told the turkey. Tuit counted the money in her wallet, $12. It might be enough to buy a turkey at the market. On Wednesday, Mama drove Tuit and Ba Noy to the Saigon market. Tuit held her wallet in her hand. Inside the store, she saw all sorts of vegetables. She saw fish, pork, duck, chicken, beef, shrimp, but no turkey anywhere. Tuit watched Ba Noy talk to the man at the counter. He handed her a package. "This duck will be delicious," Ba Noy told Tuit. Tuit put her wallet in her pocket. The next morning, good cooking smells filled the house. Tuit peeked into the kitchen. Soon, all kinds of food would be put out on the table. There would be no turkey. Tuit ran to her room and brought back the pinecone turkey she made in school. "Now there's a turkey on the table," she said to herself. She felt a little better. Her cousins, Kimberly and Min, came over at 3. They played tag outside until the grown-ups were ready to eat. "Did you know we're having duck for Thanksgiving dinner?" Tuit asked her cousins. "Yum," said Kimberly. "I love duck." "With spicy sauce," said Min. Mama called them inside for dinner. Kimberly and Min ran up the steps. But Tuit walked slowly. Was she the only one who knew that Thanksgiving was Turkey Day? "I'd like to give thanks," Daddy said when they sat down at the table, "for our home and our family. For America," Ba Noy said, raising her glass. "For all this good food," Min said, picking up his fork. "I'm hungry." Everyone laughed and passed their plates to be filled. Tuit had a little bit of everything, but she had seconds of the duck. She loved the spicy sauce and dark meat. When it was time to say goodbye, everybody hugged. "What a great Thanksgiving day," Kimberly told Tuit. It had been wonderful, Tuit thought, with lots of good food and family fun. But what would Mrs. Cook say about eating duck on Turkey Day? On Monday morning, Mrs. Cook gathered the class on the story rug. "How was your turkey day?" she asked. Tyler raised his hand. "My grandpa came. We played football." "That's nice," Mrs. Cook said. "Who else saw grandparents?" Tuit raised her hand along with the other classmates. "Who saw cousins?" Mrs. Cook asked. Tuit raised her hand again. "Who'd like to talk about their dinner?" Mrs. Cook looked around the room. Tuit put her hand down. Tears burned her eyes. "Is something wrong?" Mrs. Cook asked gently. "We didn't have turkey," Tuit blurted out. "We had duck." For a few moments, the class was quiet. Then Fong raised his hand. "We didn't have turkey either," he said. "We had noodles and chicken." "We had lamb," Tarek said. "We had roast beef," Jonathan said. "We had enchiladas," Carolina said. We had tofu turkey, Amy said. Mrs. Cook smiled. It doesn't matter what you eat on Thanksgiving, as long as you have a good time with family and friends. After school, Tuit hurried home. Mama, she called when she opened the door, I have a new name for Thanksgiving. In our house, we can call it Duck Day. The end. Did you notice that the students in Tuit's class all had different family traditions for Thanksgiving? I loved how this book showed us how diverse families can be, and that it's okay not to be like everyone else. Thanksgiving isn't about eating turkey. It's more about being with the ones you love and being thankful for the things you have. I'm glad to realize that it's okay to be different and that our family's tradition of eating duck on Thanksgiving Day is just fine. I hope you enjoyed our story today. And if you're celebrating Thanksgiving tomorrow with your family, I hope you have a wonderful time. Special thanks to Albert Whitman and Company for granting permission to read aloud Duck for Turkey Day. Make sure to get your own copy of this book so you can add it to your library. Thanks for joining me on Storytime with Tristan. To find out how you can purchase today's book, take an online reading class with me, or learn how you can purchase shirts like mine to help support fostering, adoption, education, and dog rescue, click the description below. If you liked this video, please take a moment to give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button so you can stay up to date on all my latest videos. I'll see you next time for another reading adventure.